once again, everyone join us. Thank you very much for joining us. We are starting this week a whole new playthrough playing Assassin's Creed Origins, specifically the Curse of the Pharaohs DLC. So every week for 7 weeks, we are going to have Dr. Brianna Jackson from Per Hay Studios on with us. And then also, so this week it is her as the expert guest, but then she's going to keep coming on and we'll have different experts on each week. So you can, they'll probably talk about it during the stream, but you can also find that on our website at saveancientstudies.org/events. You obviously don't necessarily have RSVP because you can watch it live on Twitch, but that's where it lists off everything. Or please like and share our posts on social media where we have the list of everyone that's coming. So really quickly, what is Save Ancient Studies? SASA stands for Save Ancient Studies Alliance. It's our mission to reverse the current downward trend in the study of the ancient world by engaging the public and bringing together students and scholars to share their passion for the study of the ancient world in order to inspire a vast new generation of students. So we do this in many ways by, of course, doing these kinds of live events. We also do book clubs, have lots of things, recordings and things on YouTube. We have a research team, an access database team that has a searchable database that now has over 1,000 websites on it. Brianna can talk more about this too. We have Core Ancient that's partnerships with a bunch of other awesome ancient studies organizations, and her studio, Per Hay Studio, is on there. Of course, you can follow SASA on basically every social media platform, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, Discord, and LinkedIn by searching Save Ancient Studies Alliance. Some quick protocol for the event, please be kind and respectful, listen and ask lots of questions. We definitely want to hear from you in the chat, that is why we're here. Also, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think this is Brianna's like kind of first time playing through this, so like the other times you kind of already played the game, but this is going to be a very much expert to react kind of thing with Brianna, so it's going to be really exciting. And that being said, the other people will probably say spoilers, aka Kate.
Then she'll say spoiler after the spoiler.
Okay, I resent. I resent this slam. Yeah, this is slander. Excuse me. Wow.
We also very excitingly now have affiliate status on Twitch, so that means you can become a supporter of SASA directly on Twitch. But you can also do this through PayPal on our website at saveancientstudies.org/donate. You can become a recurring donor for as little as $3 a month, which helps us pay for all of our subscriptions to the platform we use, pay some of our experts that we have coming in for doing these kinds of things, reading group leaders, etc. So with that, I will hand it over to our lovely SASA gamers, Kate and Alexander, and of course our guest, Brianna Jackson. Thank you.
Thanks, Lauren.
Thank you, Lauren. So hi everyone, welcome back. Did you miss sons? You should have. And if you didn't, shame on you. Anyways, so welcome to our second series of streaming and yelling and having opinions. It is an absolute delight to introduce Dr. Brianna Jackson, who is my friend. We met in 2014, oh my god, that's a long time ago, an year ago. She is an actual Egyptologist. She has got her PhD from NYU Institute of Fine Arts. And she is an expert in the Amarna period. And as you can see from Nefertiti there, we will have opinions. So Brianna, why don't you introduce yourself briefly and then we can start yelling.
Well, you already introduced me so well. I wouldn't call myself an expert. I would say specialist, really. I feel like you need decades in order to be considered an expert, in my opinion. So this is my first time playing the DLC, and I have avoided as many spoilers as I could. I already know that I'm going to meet Akhenaten, who is the pharaoh that I write about quite a lot, and I'm really looking forward to kicking his ass, because I wrote my dissertation on him, and oh my god, I need to kill him. really.
That is good. We, on this channel, we support meeting the ancients. We support not having respect for the elder, especially if the elder are pharaohs. We also think that maybe you're asking us to you. But we'll see.
And also, I should say thank you for inviting me. This is really exciting, and I'm really glad to be here. And I'm also kind of nervous to be trying to be entertaining. People will see how slow I am at playing. Sorry.
Thank you for being here.
It's gonna be a wild ride. So without further ado, let's start. Chat. Let us know if the audio's good, if we're too loud, if we're not loud. Oh yes, and this is the thirst trap. We will only play with Danny Bayek showing off his abs and chest hair and with a towel. Because it is the most historically accurate costume we could think of.
So I wonder how Diokis is faring.
Yes, good. Good. Yes. We are, on this channel, we are inclusive. So we have the beautiful women and then we have the beautiful men.
Mm.
That's all. We just like beauty. We are, we like aesthetics. That being said, Dr. Jackson, please get on the boat.
Am I going in the right direction? I can't remember.
It should be on your map.
Oh, yeah.
There's a map for that?
I meant like the right direction for the
dock.
Oh,
I think you can actually get it from the quest.
Oh. Duh. Yeah, it would help if I activated it.
What
a dummy. Okay. It's over here.
Okay,
what is it doing all the way over there? Wait. Oh, okay. I was like, why is it 8,000 meters away? It's not. The boat is closer.
It's okay.
Oh, goodness.
Do we have the first time chat in the chat by Kim Neighbor?
Oh, yes. Welcome. I know who that is. That is an esteemed colleague, Canadian, from Ontario. I know who that is. And also a bear. So, welcome. Thank you for showing yourself. She's a long-time lurker, but she has decided to make herself.
Clear the way! You.
Welcome.
She's one of my colleagues at UBC.
All right, so where are we?
I am heading to the docks because I'm meant to take a boat someplace. Oh, is it all the way over there?
Yeah, once again, I am the only person who knows what is going on in this DLC, so this is going to be exciting.
Yes, Kate is the boss. She gets to decide what quest I'm doing because we have to wait, example, for the Akhenaten for very specific special experts to join us, so...
Yeah, one of our guests has asked that we wait for him to kick Akhenaten's ass and discuss, the circumstances. I'm trying to be spoiled for the circumstances in which we will meet Akhenaten and see his city, but also not, but probably yes, city. I know that like many people in the chat have played this game and other people have not, so that's okay.
I'm sure Akhenaten is going to kick my ass many times before I finally kick his.
we should also add like some warnings for content. We are going to see a lot of dead bodies because we are going to the City of the Dead.
Headed to Thebes.
So that is like
mine is.
That's the warning that you get if you are disturbed by human remains and reanimated human remains. That's a giant spoiler. Unfortunately, this might not be the stream for you. If you're okay with destroying antiquities, this is the stream for you. So.
We have another person in chat.
Oh, hello! Hello, welcome!
I'm so excited to see Thebes. Do I get to see Amarna today, or do I have to wait?
Spoilers. Depends how forward we get.
But
okay.
I do not send you greetings, but a warning.
This way.
4 years have passed since we laid the last to rest.
Also,
but the creed spurs us ever
happy
onwards.
Happy
I have captured a messenger
bearing
news of another artifact, this time in Upper Egypt. You must go at once. Give this parcel to Merti. She lives and runs her business near Luxor. She owes me a favor, not friendship. The rest must fall to you. Find this artifact,
like, oh, yeah,
no matter the cost.
It was like laying the law straight. But yeah, and we are in a new region, just like that.
Let no one unleash its power on those we once swore to protect.
Welcome! Welcome in Thebes! You need a room? A bigger shield?
drove and we got our bodyguard? First handler.
Yeah, we're in Luxor, all right.
What is this?
The Pharaoh's curse!
As Ra lives, he landed a blow.
Whoa! Wait, I have to kill somebody right now? I'm not ready! Oh my gosh, I always have to figure out how I'm...
Nothing but a figment!
Yes, but sometimes my controller doesn't respond. Just so people know that.
Who summoned you?
Wow, this is really cool.
A lot.
Oh my god, I did. Yeah, I was up until like 4 a.m. getting up to level 45. It was pretty intense, and I couldn't sleep. Wait, seriously?
Use your bow.
Oh. Oh, I'm really bad at using a bow.
Well, I mean, if you have the machine gun bow, you can, you know.
You see, it's like I'm trying to shoot and she's moving and I can't move at the same time, and it's like...
It's okay, it's fine.
I'm so bad with a bow.
Oh, she's gone.
She's gone. Oh, wait.
Someone has the artifact. Is using it to summon the long dead. I must stop them before this cast murders all of Gapes.
Yeah, it just goes away.
Yeah.
Yeah, it will rise again.
Mamunet said reasons. Her contact was near Luxor.
Oh, they're already calling it Luxor, huh?
Yeah, they moved forward in time for, you know, how many millennia. And they're calling it Luxor already.
Ooh, let's check this out.
Look at those antiquities. Look at those statues.
That's where we're going. Wow. Oh, yes, I wanna jump into the thing. Because I like doing that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we're playing Assassin's Creed. We need to jump into haystacks and other things. Like, it is necessary. I think it's. Woo! We need to do that. At some point. I don't even jump from there. Yeah, you can. Okay. Love it. Love that for you.
I want to see what's up around here. This is so cool.
Let me check the map.
Yeah,
look at the map. And when you get to your first sync point, it's going to be fantastic. Because for now, you're like, you see a little bit. You know.
Wow.
There's a certain angle.
Is this Karnak?
Oh yeah.
Oh my god! Yeah.
Wait, so how big is it? Is it that big? Like the entire map of the deal?
Is the temple that big?
No, how can I? Like the contours of the map. But don't spoil it.
How can I not spoil this?
Yeah.
The map of the region is big enough, and then there are other maps, but I cannot tell you of what.
Okay. Oh my god, here's a harbor.
Give me credit, I'm really trying.
This is so awesome.
Not only Karnak, there's also Luxor is going to be there, Temple of Luxor is going to be there.
Oh my gosh, what is this? This is the Ramroad that they just opened up.
Yeah. They just redid it, yeah, exactly.
And
they put lights and things, and it's kind of a dance floor now, basically.
there was a really cool and over the top ceremony, and you guys can go on Luxor Times on the YouTube channel Luxor Times, and you can see. I think they have a. I think Mina put up a a recording on YouTube. So if you guys want to see the opening ceremony of this road, which was last month, and it was visited by the Egyptian president, and he did this really weird propagandistic meet and greet with the random children. I don't want to make too many comments, then I won't be able to go to Egypt anymore, but
Before we get into modern politics, maybe we should explain for the people in the chat who are not Egyptologists, where are we and why it's important and why we're freaking out about temples.
Oh! I can barely think. Well, okay. Karnak
do you want me to give,
is...
the introducing spiel, or do you want to say it while you go around, as you prefer?
Well, let me just point it out on the map again. Wait, where am I? I'm over here. So down here is actually, should be Luxor Temple. Which is not the main temple. The main temple is the Temple of Amun, which is here. And there are several pylons. It looks like it's missing a few, but that's okay. They have to, you know, economize. it's fine. And so this was the Temple of Amun. There was a Temple of Mut around here somewhere. Mut was his Amun's consort. Amun is a ram-headed god. Also, he's conflated with the sun god Re, or Ra. He preferred to say Ra. And so he became Amun-Ra, or Amun-Re. And then they had a son who was a moon god, a lunar god, whose temple was around here someplace. His name was Khonsu, and then there was also a temple around here dedicated to an earlier, a god that was the main god worshipped here in the Middle Kingdom. His name was Montu. He was a war god. But the Luxor Temple was more of like a celebration of the king being conflated with the god Amun. And so annually there was a festival that would transport the cult image of the god in a boat. They had this this handcrafted boat. It wasn't a real boat, but sometimes it was, because sometimes they would travel down the Nile, but also they would carry a boat down this processional way to meet up in this temple and celebrate the king's connection to the deity. And then it would come back again. That was called the Apit Festival. And that was one of the things that was so exciting about this recent ceremony of reopening this ram road, because it was kind of like the first Apit Festival, like legit Apit Festival since 2,000 years. So it was very exciting to see that. And I can't wait to go to Karnak. I've been there a couple of times. I want to see the ninth pylon if it's there, because that's where a lot of I'm talking too much. That's where a lot of talent
were. For the chat, a pylon is the entrance of a temple with the two trapezoidal bulwarks. That's called a pylon. And the Temple of Karnak was enlarged by everything.
You know what this guy's
supposed to be.
And so
it's not regular, because everyone added one more pile.
I have
then
no...
one more, and then one more, and then they changed the axis of it because they didn't have more space, so they added on the other axis. And then they added a lake, and then they added more lakes, and there were sacred beasts.
Make sure no one
speaks
of me.
And other things. So this is like something that goes on.
Of course.
From like the very get-go.
No feel like a tie will have the man.
And we are also in the southern part of Egypt. We are in Upper Egypt. We're not in Lower Egypt anymore.
I was told you would help me.
And this is
this is for you.
Seat.
What
of
is
the,
this?
Of the
who gave this to you?
The woman you know as
Aya. From Aethys dynasty onward, and Aethys dynasty is the
very
one
well.
With.
What do you want?
So we're like
a rare artifact.
You know, we are in a place.
I believe it is the cause of this curse.
That has always been important.
Could it be?
In the economy and history.
Rumors,
and social
whispers.
And religious. You know,
a relic was stolen from an unknown pharaoh's tomb. Some say this desecration called
the
curse down upon us.
I must find it.
Which is why when
there is quite
becomes,
a black market here
the
in Thebes. Secret
Amunet,
auctions, rare trades.
Anyway,
talk to the merchants near the docks. They will know more.
Do you see
we tell Aya our deal is done. I am headed south.
Specifically for this game.
Too close for comfort.
What if I have more questions?
Like then very, find like, Isidora, the god's wife of Amun. She will understand this curse in a way I cannot.
It's really, it's reminiscent of like these 18th, 19th century paintings, like academicist paintings from the school of Paris, I think it is.
Thank you. They, yes, Orientalism.
Really, like, yeah, Orientalism, like they were really inspired by those. If you look at those paintings, they all, you put them right next to this game, I think it's almost like it's sometimes like it's an exact copy.
The animal pelts and the candles and the flowers and all of that. Lion. I mean, you would look at the flower thing on those poles. Look at those.
Exactly.
That's fantastic. And Orientalism has entered the chat. Yes, we are never away from Orientalism, unfortunately. Ah, yeah, look at the statue of a moon with the two moons on his crown. He's cool. Where is the closest
what is he wearing?
Point? I mean, look at him.
They will attack on
sight. Sorry, what did you ask? Oh, he's wearing earrings. Look at that.
Oh, wow. Okay. Should he be wearing earrings?
Not really. I don't think so.
I think so, right?
This isn't really and I wouldn't say that this is a very accurate portrayal of a statue. It would have been a lot more gaudy and painted than this.
Oh, yeah, this is a big drab. So well, because...
Kleptomania is showing.
Yes, indeed.
True, you're right.
Like, if your great aunt or grandma has, like, an Egyptomania, I don't know, like, opulent, clock at home and there are sphinxes, they're usually black and gold, right? Or, like, anything of the sort. We can see that. They gave him the right crown, though.
Yes. That was pretty cool.
Credit where it's due.
And I like also that they include the flagpoles on the pylons here.
Yes. So, fun fact. So the flagpoles would signify the presence of the god or not, and the hieroglyph for god is the flagpole with the flag, in the wind.
See if it's in the hieroglyph.
So that is a cool thing.
Just trying to see if the hieroglyph Netcher is in here. Anyway, but I'm looking at the we're such nerds, we're like trying to read hieroglyphs, seriously.
Yes, this is going to be a nerdy stream, and we are not going to apologize for it.
But just going back on what I was talking about, the economy of and the shortening of space, the Ramrod is considerably longer than this. Karnak, you can't really see it too easily from Luxor Temple. So, and I noticed they did that with the pyramids, like with Saqqara and Giza Dahshur being very close together. But it's fine. It's okay.
Yeah, you can see everywhere from everywhere, but that's okay. That's fine. It's like it gives you like the impression of of the ancient world, but not the actual distances. Otherwise, good luck with that.
Trying to see if they. Oh no, they didn't. They don't have the proper axis here. The axis of the hypostyle hall is a little bit slanted eastward. But this is the perfect axis here.
I mean.
I'm freaking out so hard right now. in a good way. Like, I'm so excited right now.
It's okay. So in this universe, they're using Luxor as like a sort of prison camp or something. They're not actually using it as a temple.
Sacrilege.
I can't tell you how they use Karnak because you'll have to go there. So I'm not saying.
It's also remarkable that nobody is commenting on the fact that he's just wearing a towel.
I mean, it's so normal.
They should have said, you survived this deadly shadow wearing nothing but
nothing but a towel. Yeah. And that's how you know you're a badass. You just survived with a towel, with only a towel. But as one does, I mean, in this game,
whoops.
Exactly. Like, the towel part is
the inverted
axis is not. I agree, and that's how you know. Oh my god.
That was accidental entirely.
Just looking at that. It's okay. On this channel, we have well-known beef with pants in the ancient world, so that's why we chose the towel. We would not abide wearing pants in the ancient world. It's really not.
Which one?
Brianna,
which one?
To
Which one? Which one?
Why don't we go speak with this high priestess?
Really? Can we?
I mean, right? What kind of religious figure could that be?
Well, I'm scared to get too far ahead. Okay, so you know when I was playing the main quest and you get to Hermopolis, which is kind of across the street from Amarna, I was freaking out that I was going to arrive at Amarna too soon before I was ready. And then, of course, one of the kings, the successor of Akhenaten, is buried there, not in reality, but in the game he is. And I was like, oh my god, I'm so close to Amarna and blah blah blah, you know, all of this stuff. And I was panicking, I'm too early. Yeah, apparently that I didn't have to worry.
And then, no, you didn't have to worry. Also, like, buried on the wrong side of the Nile. Although by Amarna standards, maybe not, but then again, should have been. Anyway.
True.
Issues. But yeah, so you can, there are like two ways that you can go about this, and then they'll send you to the same thing. So one is you can go and speak to this high priestess. The other one is you get into a subplot of thievery and marauderry.
Wait, this says be so, level 47. You know. I'm only 45.
All right, well, then we need to grind.
So should we do no honor?
Yeah, it isn't red. You should, I think you can do it. Or you can start one and then do the other one. It's not like you're like two levels underneath the required thing.
I think my experience with this game, if it isn't like actively red,
then yeah, you can then you're cool.
Yeah. Also, right. I think if you go to Karnak, you get a viewpoint, like a sync point, I think. Seem to recall.
Oh, that's cool.
I seem to recall, yeah.
All right.
The rising should not be too difficult. Yeah, that's cool. I will get XP. Okay, let's go.
Don't you get like more XP if you kill enemies that are on your level, so you level faster?
Yeah.
Oh, for real?
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah. I think so. I'm not sure.
Well, I've got that really great. Let me show you guys what I've got here for my abilities. I've got all of. Mostly all of the warrior. I didn't include the shield stuff because I never use one.
Yeah, we don't like pairing.
And so I just like really hammered the legendary thing here. I tried to make myself strong, and I built up my health and my melee damage and my little guy over here, the hidden blade, as much as I could. I had to kill very many animals.
Unfortunately.
I'm gonna go on the ramroad, sorry.
No, go.
Because I can't do it in real life.
Also, like, well, up and rising, like the rising part, it's such a common like word to use in titles for antiquity video games. Like, it's always like Immortals Phoenix Rising or Rise of the Argonauts or something like that.
Mm. Yeah, exactly. I like what. To be fair, the Athen is kind of justified in rising because he is the sun.
Yeah,
yo!
Sir.
Look at that forge!
The Oppid Festival is happening! Can I climb it?
Totally random.
Can I? No, I can't climb up there. And there's this guy who's like, fanning it.
Please let me.
How amazing is this? And yes, they shield the statue of the god from, everyone's sight. Shouldn't these be ram-headed boat ends?
Yeah, they should be, unless that one is Khonsu and they got him his hip.
Why is there a baboon there? Is that also?
I don't know, man. There's also Ta.
There's Ta. We're just gonna throw all kinds of gods in there. Why not?
It's a very intimate festival. It's only for the people in the family. Yeah, exactly. Everyone's at home. Also, I love that everyone is wearing like leopard skin. But, like, the leopard skin inflation in this game is fantastic. They're like full of leopards.
Yeah. And oh, here we've got more hieroglyphs on the ground, which I actually have a problem with. It's not like a problem, but it's just that they wouldn't put hieroglyphs on the ground because this is a sacred text, you know, it's not like it's hieratic or something, but hieroglyphs are sacred. They only appear on religious monuments for the most part. I mean, also, I guess palaces might have it, but they wouldn't put it here on the ground. They do that at Hermopolis too. I have so many problems with Hermopolis.
So many
like
with Hermopolis, like we're gonna have like a special in this game. But I mean,
Then they're copy and paste obelisks.
Yeah, exactly. Well,
that's okay.
So this is Karnak.
Yes.
In their vision. I do love that once you enter, you'll see. Well, you'll see. And this is also my background on Zoom usually.
Oh, is it? Oh!
Yes! Yes! You'll see exactly my background on Zoom as you approach the quest.
I kind of want to light this, can I? I want to light the...
Light yourself a bow, oh my god! Oh my god, buy it!
Oh, you don't like my fire? Oh, look how he's so burnt now!
It's microfiber.
Oh, wow. Look at these papyrus bundle columns. They have a lot of screen walls in here that are very Ptolemaic.
Very Ptolemaic. Yeah, with the crown of Uray, that is like Ptolemy 101.
Yes.
Moon. This time he's got the thing. So that's good.
He's got the thing? What thing?
He's got the thing. He's holding the... What's it? The copish? Is that a copish that he's holding? Oh, like tiny?
Oh, yeah!
Oh, look,
Well, let's climb up there and get a closer look. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, what's missing are the proper decorations on pylons. I noticed that throughout the game. I mean, not every pylon in Karnak had the smiting scenes, but I haven't. Have I? I don't think I've seen any smiting scene on any pylon.
We don't have any of them. We have very Ptolemaic offering scenes, but like usually, especially in the Dynasty pylons, you have giant images. Somebody's doing stuff. Pharaohs smiting their enemies on a chariot, on foot, killing people, holding people by their heads before killing them, just, trampling them with their chariots, all of it, like the whole hullabaloo. It's like, when you want to have a massacre scene, you put it on a pylon, because it's sacred. And on some, I think it's one on Karnak, but I don't know. There's actually sometimes a moon is like giving the weapon to kill the enemies to Pharaoh. So that it's sacred because it's sanctioned by the god, right? I mean, he told me to do so, so clearly I have to kill these people. Anyways, state violence, always a classic.
So we have randomly cartouches on these abacuses on top of the column capitals. I'm holding on to what's called an abacus. Pharaoh's shadow has arisen. Where? Yes, this is the name of Amenhotep III, which weirdly also appears in Smenkhkare's tomb. And here they have the epithet connected also, beloved of Amun-Ra.
Oh,
Mary Amun-Ra.
So Amenhotep III was Akhenaten's dad.
Yes. I came up here to show off these ties. I like these so much.
Oh, that's nice. With the grapples, we love that.
Yeah,
love that.
That's a nice detail.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Did we
already say that this is going to be nerdy? This is really nerdy? We love the nerdiness. And we take no issue with it. Let me mute myself for a second, because I think they are refilling the oil tank. So I might be able to shed some layers.
Thank you, because I got fighting for you. For your first time, chat. Also, just the fact that it's all black painted.
Yes.
Like in Odyssey as well. Like, that's. It's great that they implemented that, because we always have to think about the ancient world as like this white marble place. But, I mean, it totally wasn't.
Yes, absolutely. And also recently, they just did a huge conservation project in the Hypostyle Hall, which is it's like a room full of columns, basically, for those who don't know what that is. They restored, just from cleaning, all of the colors in on the columns, and it's so vibrant now. It's really incredible.
Yeah, actually, I saw this paper a couple of weeks ago that said that, researchers, academics love the fact that it's all colored in this game, but that many fans or players of the game, they thought it was weird, that they thought it was boring because they were accustomed to, like, a monochrome idea.
Sucks for them.
So, but I think it's interesting, like, that divide into how ingrained that image has become in, like, the popular imagination.
Is it already I Blame Everything on Winkelmann time? is it let's say, it'll be like Met O'Clock already? Because I'm always ready for that. I think the shadow has left.
Yes, it has.
I think it did.
Okay, yeah.
I was going to see if I could assassinate it from above, but it disappeared. Whoa, hey!
It was like,
oh, we got a dead guy over here. Oh, sorry, my dude.
Oh, yeah, but
I didn't save
there.
You.
Sorry, sir. You're not supposed to be there.
Look,
sir,
at these papyri.
Sir,
see,
sir, please don't die.
Sir, please don't die here. You're not here. This sacred ritual place.
Amun-Ra Horakhti.
Okay, the game audio is a bit loud.
Secrets of expression and shimmering of
form.
Oh,
yeah, I can lower the volume.
Come forth. Purified. Purified is the Lord of Thebes.
Look at her headdress there.
She's fantastic.
You.
She's fantastic.
Lurking in the shadows. I should
be
angry.
Wait until you see her eyeliner.
But you are in the house of the hidden
one. Oh, that's pretty fantastic.
What is your business?
I should recreate that for next time.
Bayek of Siwa. I am looking for the source of the curse that plagues Thebes.
You are no priest?
Oh yeah,
okay,
just like casually half naked in the
and
presence.
And the oasis is far from here. What do you care for our troubles?
Hello?
Because they are not just your troubles.
People have to explain after
this
the
curse,
talk.
It stems from a relic.
Who is this woman?
And countless suffered at the hands of the men who wielded another like it.
Wearing a leopard skin as well?
You have suffered more than most.
Whoa.
Amun sees deep into your heart.
She's got tattoos too.
But it is not men.
Oh yeah.
Or relics by
Amun's
ire
have a
is fearful.
Vaguely
the pharaoh's wreak is punishment for the thieves'
massacre.
You believe this is your lord's will?
Amun comes to deprive the poor and distressed.
There may or may not be.
Then who in Thebes has reason to call him?
Many things have been stolen from us. Relics, lives, innocence. The curse does not distinguish between rulers and subjects. But, perhaps, in the farmlands, another pharaoh walks there, but the people have escaped his ire.
I will find out why.
Speak to them, then tell me this.
Oh, her headdress has the modius with the urea around it. In the back it does. I'm like so excited right now.
And these farmers really welcome the curse.
So this unfortunately not scantily dressed woman is the god's wife of home, which is a title that by that point should have not existed anymore, but we forget about this, we don't care about that. That is basically the highest religious position that a woman could obtain in ancient Egypt. It was usually reserved for members of the royal family. It was actually created to, cram a member of the royal family in the clergy of Amun. And so this
maker of men,
this priestess
beasts
would be
and herbs,
the one who knew all the secrets of the cult of Amun. She would be the one who would be performed very specific rituals, of which we cannot speak here. On the statue of Amun, she would be, you know, praying to him, chanting for him, and, you know, embracing him. Weird things. But also, she would be a religious authority. On the one hand, because she was part of the royal family. On the other hand, because she was part of the clergy. So it was like an 18th dynasty thing to get someone in, 17th dynasty actually, to get someone in the family. in the clergy moon, because the clergy moon was powerful in every possible sense of the word. And the things that she's wearing are a little, it's a little pastiche of things. But generally speaking, she's wearing all the paraphernalia of the priest of Amun. She's wearing the two plumes, which are like the, which is the typical crown of Amun. She's wearing, what the hell is that? She's got the thing made of feathers, which I don't know where they got from, but it's really cool.
It's like part vulture and part winged scarab or something. That's kind of what it looks like.
Yeah, right. The whole thing with the wings is weird, but we stand nonetheless. She's wearing a leopard skin because priests self-made would wear leopard skins, and when they didn't have the actual thing, they would make them fake. They would paint the spots on them. There's actually one of them in the Brooklyn Museum. It's not an actual leopard skin. It's like a skin on which they painted the spots. And yeah, she's phenomenal. She's wearing some very nice transparent linen, which is very accurate, because we know that high-quality Egyptian linen was very sheer, so you could kind of make out the details of the body underneath, but not quite. So there's also like an erotic component in using this kind of linen. She's wearing fabulous sandals. And all of that, I don't know where they got that from. It's fantastic, but it looks very cumbersome.
Refashioned your body.
I mean, you know, who am I to, you know,
soul one,
to contest that? But yeah, so she's in charge here. By this point in history, in real time, this position would not exist anymore.
Maker of men.
But
beasts and herbs.
I mean, I can't spoil too much, but there's a reason why they put it in here. Because plot.
Kate had a lot of stuff to say about this lady. You've given some thought to this.
I always think about religious figures. I bet you thought I always think about women, but no, I'm a serious woman. But also, she has a Greek name.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, once again, she's mixed. She doesn't have a Egyptian name. Isidora is very Greek, so. You know?
Most of the people called
It's the gift of Isis. Plus, like, it's a composite name. That's even better. That's even better because it's like, at this point, you know, everyone and their grandmas is in Egypt, so that's fantastic.
Because I know, like, in Odyssey, they didn't care about, like, the actual name, because Alexios is the name that
doesn't exist.
Maybe someone in the chat knows, but I think that name is more like a late antiquity.
Yeah, it does sound more like. Also, look at the graffiti, because, yes, ancient people tagging.
I was gonna say, is this like somebody tagged the building? Is this like a gang member lives here? But look at these pectorals hanging up here.
Yeah, so those are, they're using those as like amulets, kind of like dream catchers, but actually those are pectorals, and like one of them is for the people to kind of Tutankhamun. So you would actually wear them like on your chest, and they're pretty heavy, and they would have like a counterweight on the back. So that you would not like slump forward, because those things are heavy. You heard it here first. Gold is heavy. Also, I like how generous they are with the use of faience, especially in Thebes. There are people who are selling amulets, and I went bonkers. My dissertation is on faience thingies, so I went absolutely haywire.
Wait, can I just ask for the chat? Is the audio better now?
Yeah.
We can't hear the game, so it's, let us know if the audio is missing.
And look at this, we've got Atens painted on here as well. So we got the Eye of Horus gang and the Aten gang.
This is a surprise, this is West Side Story, but
the Ankh gang.
So it's West Bank Story. And now, I met a girl named Maria, but actually the name did not exist. So,
outfit.
Oh, what are you wearing? Let's take a look. I like how they give different kinds of costume to the people in different cities. Like in Memphis, there are some people who are dressed very elaborately in elaborate Egyptian clothes. And here, I guess they have different body adornments. It's so cool. I like how they did that.
Yeah. No, it's nice, and it's also cool, like how in here everyone is being Egyptian.
Yeah.
No one is yelling at you in Greek.
Did they? I read somewhere. Did they like ask like linguist or like politician like what Egyptian would sound like at this moment in time? I think I heard that there is no
of the Egyptian language?
Yes, I read somewhere that so for the Greek and the Latin they didn't have many problems, but for the Egyptian, is it like the modern Egyptian or Middle Egyptian? I'm not an Egyptologist, I don't know what I'm saying. But I read that they had to reconstruct
you people owe us money, so pay up. Tihun's order.
Well, we make an attempt to pronounce Egyptian from our transliteration.
You have these fields and your lives because
we
of
use,
his
so
good
you,
grace.
We'll look at the hieroglyphs or the hieratic, and then we translate that into Latin letters with diacritical marks, and so we come up with sounds based on that. And a lot of times some sound comes from the Coptic language, which is a very late form, and it's like the only form that I guess you could say that ancient Egyptian survived in some Coptic. So the way of pronouncing comes from that as well. And then we also have the correspondences with the ancient Near East, like people from Babylonia and Assyria and all of these. And so they would write to the kings, and they have a certain way of pronouncing, they have to write the king's name. Yeah, they have to write it in cuneiform, and so of course they would have different sounds, probably. But it's kind of interesting to maybe reconstruct a sound based on that. But we cannot say that we have it 100% correct.
You people owe us money, so pay up.
Is it
like the people that are loud?
Hasn't he trampled us?
Is the ambient sounds there allowed? Yeah, no, I remember that. I can't hear it because it's muted on my computer.
Got it at 60.
As always, thank you for
sound effects. Okay,
thank you for
that's. How about I turn all of these down? I'll turn this one down to audio dynamic range. I don't know what that is.
I have no idea.
Alright, I'm gonna put my other earphone in so that I can.
Let's see. Thank you, chat. We're always.
This is the first time we're doing this.
It's always a struggle.
You have these fields and your lives because of his good grace.
If we watched Valhalla, we were yelling.
It is the dialogue that's really loud. I'm listening to it now. Yeah, it's. How do I turn the dialogue down? Because it didn't have that option.
No
dialogue boost.
But at zero.
If anybody in the chat knows how to change that, let us know, because we don't want to be overpowered by NPCs.
By peasants. They're nonsense.
You people owe us money, so pay up!
Just like you told us.
Hasn't he trampled
you
us?
You alone, silent.
Trample.
risen.
Where is this guy?
Don't make me laugh. And the gods, you have these fields and your lives because of his good grace.
It is desecration.
Okay.
We will experiment on Monday.
Yeah. Well, I just killed that guy who was shouting because he was annoying, so hopefully that helps.
Good. So for now, that is done. So now we are on murder she wrote.
Seven times, and seven times, both on the stomach and
so
on the
we'll
back.
Have to do some investigation.
What game are you playing, child?
It is not
the
a game.
Jessica Fletcher.
I am making a ceremony to the sun.
To Ra?
No.
Look at this fucking
to the true
hair.
God.
Where did you learn that?
I mean...
Jehuti. He protected us. Saves us from the cursed one. But they stole him away.
Someone took Jehuti? Who?
Bad men.
Jehuti. So if they're meaning that the true God is Aten, since it's called Aten Rising, I think it's cool that they used the name Jehuti because that was a popular
Jehuti,
name during the Amarna
like
period.
Us. You alone, shining,
In
risen.
Greek, was Thoth.
When he comes, men hide,
yep,
and the gods fly away.
Yeah, but it's
not a typical village fire. This looks ceremonial.
This looks ceremonial. Bayek, you can say ritual.
Is it? Yeah, isn't that what archaeologists always say? It's,
where is your,
it's ritual.
Yes. For the people who don't know, my Discord
a lot of oil.
Is Valka with sunglasses.
More than a village of this size would need.
So yes, we will link it.
That's an inventive way to include red barrels into your explosive red barrels.
Oh yeah, exactly. It's the same asset for all games.
It literally is.
It's amazing.
Some awesome suit.
Where else can I go? Can I come in here?
Oh, we fall at the feet of the king.
Should I climb the roof?
Sun, our god.
I think you might have
seven
to.
Times and seven
or
times,
jump
both
into
on the stomach
house.
And on the back.
Oh, no, that's a thing
on
the.
Yeah,
ah.
That
Ra, bless you, Neb.
On the roof.
Two less of those bunches looking the black
there.
Land.
Oh, I killed them.
You have many troubles here.
Tihon's men are the least of it. People disappear every day. To the cursed lands, or those damned bandits.
Bandits are taking people.
Yeah.
Why?
Why do bandits do anything?
Depends.
For their own fiendish reasons.
Neb-Nebis, Lord of all.
Jehuti
or
must be the priest the bandits took.
Or Neb-Neb.
You will know more about this class.
Yeah, also the usual title for women is Nebet Per, which is the lady of the house, the mistress of the house. And the coolest, I think, of the goddess's titles is Nebet Per.
Join me, and we will rescue
sky.
Our priest.
Beautiful. Okay.
They will pay for taking one of our
It also has to do
own.
With a cow, so, you know. Anyways, the celestial cow. Anyways. I swear no drugs were taken before this dream, which is a lot of warm tea. So we are rescuing Jehuti, whoever that is.
I am choosing not to ride my horse, although my horse is awesome. Just in case we find something interesting along the way to discuss. And also because I just want to see what's up.
Also, yeah, she's trying to run into as many people as possible. You haven't seen when we did the test ride for this, she slaughtered innocents left and right. Poisoned people. They were puking and she was like, ha ha ha, look at those losers. We were like,
don't forget firebombing.
What? What? What's going on here?
Oh yeah, right. She entered. Oh my god, we're gonna do her. She entered the Hermopolis temple and set it on fire. She set the whole thing on fire and then wanted to kill baboons. That is the kind of person.
Then I dumped that one guy in the river.
That's very true. Very true. I told the other guy who saw you dump it to just shut up. Otherwise, bad things will happen. I'm Financial Mobster's problem.
What's going on? Ada! Who fireballed me?
Oh my god, then now you're on fire then.
Somebody shot me from behind. Bastard.
I mean, honestly, there's no decency left.
No, there isn't.
You can't say there's no decency left when you run around with a big axe.
You must be the priest of bandits.
Okay, but we have a man. You will know more about this class. The God's wife of a moon. Right? She told us to come.
Indeed.
We're kind of in the right here. You know, if a moon says we need to, then we need to.
Chivalry is dead.
Right. Okay. Thank you, Senu.
Oh, that is so pretty.
Oh, bless. So Senu, best girl. Somebody was gonna chase me. So we are still on the east bank.
Oh yeah. Yes, we are still on the east bank. So
there should not be anything dead over here.
Yeah, no. So the east bank is where all the religious buildings would be, and the west bank is where all the mortuary, funerary buildings would be. Which does not mean small things by any means. But if you had to build a tomb or a funerary temple, you would put it on the west bank, and then everything else would be on the east bank. So if you wanted to go, you know, visit grandma, grandpa, all your dead, you would have to cross the river. Because, you know, west is where the sun dies, and east is where the sun rises, again with the rising. And so you know, there is that. Also, someone in the chat is saying, I'm finding this game is amazing. I set my camel on fire only by coming close with a torch. I think we should attempt. but then we would get flagged for animal cruelty, probably. Yeah.
Poor camel.
I mean, everything can be set on fire if you try hard enough. Oh, but look at all those beautiful
such
red
as...
jars. You can set this whole camp on fire, Brianna. I would consider. My God, you know.
Yes. I think I really like the fire in Valhalla.
Yes.
Better than here.
Yeah, like arsonism, fantastic. Like Eivor, yes.
Yeah, but like just like the way the fire, like I read it out, the way it looked, it was
yes
so much more realistic.
Yeah,
because I remember in Odyssey, for example, like you would drop a torch and then all of a sudden all the textures would pop up and be black. Like,
yes.
But in Valhalla, it like gradually spread and stuff like that. So yeah.
Yeah, no, it makes a lot of sense. I like it. In here, I think we can't do stealth anymore. But who knows? Maybe we will.
Oh, they found me, so unfortunately they do know what's coming.
Oh, well, yes.
Next time we should call Sasa Gaming Team Burns
Egypt to the ground.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Yes, Sasa Gaming Team kills everyone. Hey James, how you doing? We're not looking for hedges in this stream, but who knows? Maybe we will. We're slaughtering everyone that, you know, that meets us, as one does.
Come closer, my
sir.
My dude. Thank you. Look at this guy, he's just strolling around and he sees everybody else fighting and he's just like, nothing's happening here.
Yeah, no, it's all good, we're good, sir.
Oh, come on. Come closer.
Oh, come on, come play with us.
Oh, I should go hide for a little while so my health comes back up. Is anybody looking for me? Oh, well, there's a couple of guys over there. Look how bloody he is! Ah, that's fantastic. I love it. Yes, he has.
We enjoy.
Painted with red. Okay. All right, we're back in town, guys.
Call me crazy, but I think something.
Yeah.
Kill you. On fire. Well, good thing he has a towel. That's very
yes!
true. That's very true. Also, wow, you really are destroying them. Yes, good. This is the content.
Die, maggot!
This sir.
My Seriously? Lord, my son, my You're telling God. Me to die? Oh, yes, that was fantastic.
The last thing he heard was...
You're telling me to die? So, really?
Before I save this guy, I need to get that treasure.
Yeah, oh, there's one more guy there.
Release
me from this prison.
I'll okay, get well. To you, don't worry. Let me kill all these people. Why assassinate when you can just throw his body on a fire? Look at that! Oh, I love it. That's fantastic. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
This is the level of derangement we really need in these trying times.
Alright, let's hope I get something good out of here. A shield? Oh, who cares about shields? Bone Picker Hideout, I like this name.
It's very pretty.
Okay, let me go save Juhuti.
You might get some cool... Yeah, save Juhuti. You might get some cool shield from the first serious mission in the maps, of which
Release
I cannot
me from
speak.
This prison.
If I remember correctly.
I have nothing you want,
Look,
bees!
Look, the Gusky's, You have to step up here, too.
Just me, you save,
why did they put
Who
him
are you that
the,
does Akhenaten's bidding?
The amulets.
Let us escape
like,
this place.
Like, is that a zoo? Like, what is that?
Wait, where? I'm sorry, I missed that. I was...
In the tent.
He's sitting, like... Yeah, he was sitting surrounded by animals. Oh! It's okay.
Yeah, like animal statues.
Let's take a look. Yeah. Now that I know this picture mode and that I can zoom and stuff. Look at all these cats.
Well.
There's Anubises, yeah. There's Hathors,
there's William.
William is everywhere.
Yeah, for the ones not in the know, William is the large faience hippo that is at the Met Museum. His name is William. Well,
oh my God.
His American name is William. So every hippo is William for us.
There's a whole pile of stuff in here. How come I can't take from here, man? That's some real treasure. Look at that. I don't need no shield. I've got so many shields.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Sir.
Who needs that? Yeah, I wonder how they are getting that stuff. From where? Could that be a plot point in general?
Oh, is that you being, not spoilering, but...
Indicating
that there's something.
That perhaps we are dealing with a looting issue in the necropolis.
Ooh.
Perhaps. You know, it's which is actually historically accurate. We know that the necropolis was being looted, and we know that they were trying to set up, you know,
the
police and other
sanctuary.
Things, and not even fines for looting tombs, like literally just, you know, death penalty. But people were looting nonetheless, because there's gold and it's there, and the dead don't need it, honestly.
You risked your life for mine.
Those were the days.
The curse. I must have what you know.
He has killed many. I was trying to purify his shrine at the farm, but the bandits took me. They fear the Aten comes at my command.
You worship the heretic.
He's trying to purify his shrine.
Akhenaten, we offer up piety, songs and rituals, and he does not come for us.
I
can show you,
words.
But the farm, the animals rot. They
I see that there's bias here.
I will go to the farm. Anytime.
Heretic.
Tell me what you know of the pharaoh.
Yes.
Excuse me.
Must resume our nightly rituals. Find me at the southern farm after
First
the sun sets and the corruption is gone.
Like the average Ptolemaic time person from Siwa know who the fuck Akhenaten was? I don't think so.
Especially since they erased his name from everywhere.
Right, the whole point was that they enacted this beautiful damnatio memoria, because they were like, yeah, no, we're not doing this shit anymore. So people would not know who he was. Like, that was the whole point. They dismantled. They tried to erase him so much that they dismantled the new city that he built into small pieces called Taladat, and then put those inside the pylons of the other temples so they would not be found. So, like, think how much effort and hate you need to have to dismantle a whole city. Just, you know, like, they really put in the effort to make his name disappear from history, and then, you know, and then In comes Bayek from C1. He's like, oh yeah, Akhenaten. Oh yeah, that dude.
I know that guy.
I mean,
the guy who did the stuff.
Like, pretty big library.
That's very true. But.
So, yeah.
But still, like, I don't know if at the point, even like the people who were compiling histories and lists of pharaohs at that time would have known about Akhenaten.
Mm.
Because the evidence was literally buried. Like, they buried the lead.
There was a site where Aten just continued to be part of the name, and this was in Nubia, which is modern-day Sudan, and also southern Egypt, modern-day southern Egypt. But in a site that was actually called Gem Aten, or Gempa Aten, now it's called Kawa. And even in the 25th dynasty, they continued to call this Gempa Aten, which is really exciting to know.
Yeah. I've been there. I worked there.
You went to, you, seriously? Ah, I pressed the button.
Kawa.
So slow.
I didn't know that.
I walked on the roof of the temple. Yeah. Kawa is a place where there's a lot of wind. And so the temples are now buried, and so you can walk on the roof of the temple. So yeah, a very interesting excavation. A very windy place. I forgot to mention scorpions. Yes, that was the other part of my Sudanese experience, all of scorpions.
Really?
Yeah, with scorpions.
Those the fatal ones?
I mean, if you're very sick, or a child, or an old person, yes. Mm. If you're a reasonably healthy person, they're not gonna kill you. You're gonna be very uncomfortable. But they don't seem to have a lot of interest in, you know, being an asshole to you if you let them be. That being said, please do not go pet scorpions. Please do not. We are not endorsing that. Yeah, exactly. Don't try it at home. Did I pet a scorpion? No. Would I tell people this? Absolutely not. Are we committing arson?
If nothing else,
yes.
The decaying animals will
excellent.
No longer
so that's
take
the point
land.
Of the mission. For once, we have to set everything on fire. So that's it's like it's literally part of the thing. We need to. Yeah. Okay. That's good. That's good. Exactly. We've been preparing for this. Where's the fun in not petting scorpions? I don't know. I think they're beautiful creatures. I think they look very slick. I don't know if they like being pet, to be honest. Do we have an entomologist? Yeah, I don't know. Do we have an entomologist in the chat? Or, you know. But, and spoiler, if you want to pet scorpions, there will be scorpions in this DLC.
For real?
Not the petting kind, yes.
Oh.
Not the petting kind.
They got a circuit?
Him after the sunset.
You could make it.
They will be making preparations for their nightly ritual.
Right? You need the scorpions.
Yeah.
You need the snakes. You need the crocodiles. You need the hippos. You need the lions. The mummy. You need the pelt. The animal pelt. You need the,
curses? Yeah.
Oh, who am I fighting? Oh, blessed. This is somebody different from the... Is it somebody different?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Oh my god, that's so scary! I don't like the way it's moving! Oh...
Brianna, do you want a big spoiler?
No, spoil me. Because I'm afraid of zombies, so if that helps
that's
me.
Your boy!
That's what I thought!
That's
he looks really
that's
freaky.
Him. Yeah, he's tall and lanky. That's Akhenaten. Well, one of
it
his.
Is.
Oh, yeah.
One of his shadows.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Hey.
Did that asshole kill a child? Is this a child? Oh, no, it's not a child. He looked very small.
Is it like in Immortal Phoenix Rising with like the shades? Did you play that?
I would play the fifth.
I'm
gonna play the fifth.
In the mortal is exact. You have like Achilles, Odysseus, Heracles, and Atalanta, and they're all dead, but they return to like haunt you as shades until you defeat them. So maybe.
Sorry.
I mean, I think going for what I've seen is kind of is the same gameplay mechanic, maybe, but they might be technical.
Yeah, it's a yes but no, but like the even when you beat the DLC, the shades keep rising.
Oh really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Or because they give you shards of stars.
Oh.
And so like
that's helpful.
Yeah.
What a blessing the priest has returned.
When he was gone, I broke the statue of men I kept by my door. I hope the pharaohs are pleased.
Oh!
The wounded
would
hear us when we called him.
The pharaohs have proven themselves more powerful.
You will understand.
Oh, great! That's fantastic.
So you need to meditate and wait for nightfall. Yes.
Look at that landscape. Oh, I can't wait to go into the West Bank, man. Yeah. Another pharaoh show.
Thank you for being with us, Kim. We'll see you next week. Yeah. Pretend to work.
Thank you for coming.
Alright, and now...
I have done what you asked.
Then we cannot act too soon.
Sir,
for the sake of all who make the farmlands their home.
Talk to me.
Please, Baek, join us for the ritual. See how we appease the pharaoh Akhenaten.
Yes, let's do that.
Me and my people. Come, you should take part in our ceremony.
I shall.
Everything is prepared. The Aten rises. Will you honor
for
him?
For next time, drink again. Every time anyone says ritual,
he must be important, or Jehuti would not allow it.
We just go. Those are metal skull cups called. I don't know, do they have a name?
You rise.
Not
perfect.
That I know of.
Singular.
My knowledge of crowns is pretty terrible. Collect the silica from the offering table.
All be. God without equal. Your force, the living
Aten,
risen and resplendent, distant and near.
There are mountains in Thebes on the other
Lord
side
of the
river.
Two lands, son of Ra, the one living on Maat. Your strength
the
lives within these
is,
offerings, sparse but unbroken.
Mountain that was sacred to Hathor.
He has given him a great honor.
There are mountains there. I don't know if they're in the right place. I don't know
upon
if
the statues of the
right place. Once it's like daylight, we're gonna check and ask which is not me.
Well, I don't think that Assassin's Creed needs like these environmental things to compress the
as long as they stand whole and untainted,
you
will live in
the
art.
End of the map, it just says,
yeah, it says goodbye.
Like
so it's not like in...
You are our desire. There is no other who knows you.
Skyrim,
our eyes fall upon your perfection.
But some games, they do tend to have, like, environmental...
A light!
Alright!
What?
Yes, in your son, enfold him in your
arms to join.
Living forever.
What is this?
All came forth in existence from your hand. When you rise, they live. When you set, they die.
This is so funny. It's like a giant fireball.
Rise, oh, living eternal Lord.
Okay.
That's so funny.
Join me.
They are using words from the hymn to Aten.
Have the scales
because,
fell
like, slightly you rise is literally the beginning of one of them.
Yeah.
The pharaoh Akhenaten is the son of the Aten.
I believe that his power is fearsome. In return for honoring him, we have our lives. Can you say the same for those who bow before Amun?
This cult is heresy. What texts even speak of Akhenaten?
What?
Well, that's then how do you know who he is, man?
But that chiseler Tichon
has
closed
like
the library to all but his thugs and thieves.
I will find a way in.
Look for a statue in the archives, pointing towards some crumbling scrolls. One speaks of the Aten and a temple lost for centuries.
Look at his pectoral. It's an Aten with her hands. Look at that.
You think that we worship an abomination?
That's so cool.
That I'm damning my people.
He really went for the look.
I cannot judge the path you took. Not when mine is strewn with the dead.
Loot a tomb. I and that's how you steal the look. I'm seeing myself up. I'm gonna go. It's just
finding Ahenaten's temple should lead me closer to the relic. And who has it?
Yeah, you know, I was actually just thinking, just looking at the quest update here. We said reach. Wait, there was something else. It said to see like the origin or whatever that it said. I was actually just thinking while this guy was talking about how they didn't really give a prologue to what all of this is about. Like, they just dived into saying the Aten, and Akhenaten, but they didn't, like, explain what that means to the player. I mean, for me, I know everything, but, you know, for people who don't know, I'm wondering if there's anybody in the chat who played this game and doesn't really know about this time period, what you thought of the storyline here, if it made sense to you. I'm interested to see what people have say about
did
that.
Did you fall into a Wikipedia googling black hole, just looking up, you know, Akhenaten, and then ended up looking, you know, at all of his ancestors?
No joke, that's how I played Valhalla.
Oh, really?
Go through and everything. So I mean, that's part of the experience. I mean, it's the learning, I think. But you're right that right now all of these are just like names, I think.
Yeah, right now all the information you are given is that there was a heretic pharaoh. They don't tell you how long ago.
Oh.
Like for as much as you know, it could have been like 10 years ago.
And they don't
and
really...
Then, like, his name was erased.
They don't really establish that it's a sun god, at least not that I've recognized. I mean, maybe I just didn't pay much attention, enough attention, but it seems to me like they kind of skipped over what Aten is.
Yeah.
No, that's true.
Yeah.
It's not a fireball, it's a sun.
You there! Stop!
I mean, people criticize these games for... I mean, they obviously use history and mythology as like the sort of enveloping of their game, but in the end, the basic game of what you're actually doing is not like historical or anything at all. Like the history is like it's a nice, I mean, layer on top of the cake, you could say. Like it ties it all together and it's beautiful, but in the end, they could do more with it.
Mm.
Maybe that applies.
So what is this giant Greek thing doing in Thebes?
How do I get up there?
I think there's a door.
Oh, is there?
I think there was a door on the other side.
Oh.
Or there may be an open window. From the chat, James is saying, knowing nothing about Egypt, for me this DLC story was one of those Ubisoft are using AC to create sort of more mythical stuff that doesn't need to make much sense.
Mm.
So it was good fun, but I took it with a big pinch of salt. Yeah, I mean, many of the things that like... you hear in this DLC sound like they made it up, like, oh yeah, heretic king with, you know, who worshipped the sun and all of that, and it's like, yeah, yeah, you know, same old, but some of the things they got right. Not the fact that the name of Akhenaten would survive this late in history.
Is there an open door? Whoops. I didn't realize it was off limits at the time. Thought it was one of those that the Roman guard is there, but it's okay that he's there.
Well, time for slaughter. It's fine.
Maybe I should go into sneak mode here. Ooh, some treasure.
Yeah. Some Romans? Some Greeks? Probably, yes.
I mean, Greeks, sure.
Hmm.
But Romans, this is when it is like Roman domination came 10 years later.
Far away by now.
So,
not yet.
Had to stay alert.
Someone said playing the DLCs in Egyptologies was like descending into madness, especially the conclusion. But it was a lot more fun than the main quest for me. it was a lot of fun. I think this is my favorite DLC. For now, we'll see what Valhalla gave us, but like, it was fantastic. Hey, Sunny!
You're a big
nice. Look at Brianna being stealthy.
Yeah, like she's...
And then axing people left and right.
Because I'm not stealthy enough. Actually, he had a higher level than I did, so it didn't let me assassinate. Oh, you talking to me, bro? What you want?
What you want?
What?
Get lost. Get lost. Sir, get...
Hey! Get cool.
Oh shit!
Ouch! Ouch! Ouch!
Sorry,
that's
it.
Well, have...
I was scared for a second there.
My book is late, so
I'm trying. Right, channeling his inner Karen and say, but I have a right to be here.
Jehoti said that the statue pointed him to the scroll.
Who's this guy? Got a cool outfit. He's wearing a towel on his head like me. But he's too scared to wear his bath towel, so... I win.
Exactly.
Oh, look! It's, Augustus. The prima porta.
It's Alexander.
With an Augustus pose.
Yes, exactly. It's like the prima porta Augustus, but like...
This is it.
Alexander.
The statue Jehoti spoke of. It is pointing high up on that shelf.
It's pointing at the shelf?
Oh my god. It is... What is it?
X-Minds the spot!
Angels and demons all over again.
Oh yes! Oh yes, the angels were pointing at the angel.
The temple door is hidden. There is a scrolled note here. Tihon's men are also looking for Akhenaten's sanctuary.
Sure, I mean, the person who hid it made sure that the statue was
stumbled in darkness.
Because there are no other statues of angels in the world, right?
It is you, Akhenaten, living in darkness, descendants.
We
built this shrine, temple in honor of you. When you rise on the eastern horizon, the light reveals the true path. Note from Tihon's men, I'm sick of looking. This temple to the heretic is a myth, nothing more. Stop calling him a heretic! That's actually a very, Ramesid point of view of Akhenaten, and there are Egyptologists who literally hate Akhenaten. I'm not gonna name names, but there's a book, and it's insane. And for some reason, it seems like the Egyptologist took very personal offense to this pharaoh. It's so bizarre.
Existing?
Yes.
I mean, it's not my favorite time period, but, I mean, the guy did nothing to me, personally, so, right?
The phrases that this scholar used was iconoclastic freak. In a publication.
Iconoclastic?
Yes.
Freak?
Yeah.
It's a little heavy.
Weird.
It's also like a charged term.
Yes. And a lot of people, a lot of people put the term heretic in quotation marks, which is better. But I think that this comes from that papyrus that mentions, quote, that heretic king or that heretic or whatever it was that it said. And I feel like Egyptologists had kind of just gone along with it, especially because there's a kind of like, oh, I was gonna say something really inappropriate. It's like kind of like they're jerking off Ramesses, and they just go with whatever he said. You know, that's what it seems like to me sometimes.
Oh, that's right. You know, they're all simping for Ramesses. We're here first. But it's true. So. To give people more context about this, because Egyptologists have, we're not gonna name any names, but they have beef with people that, you know, have died 3,000 years ago, and they have beef with each other for which people they hate. So after Akhenaten's experiment, let's call it experiment, was ended, because he died and his successors went back to Thebes and a more traditional approach to kingship and religion, the following dynasty dismantled everything, and they decided to just, you know, erase everything. And they made some efforts into depicting this period of time as like a deviation from order, as heresy, as anything of the sort. So like, that's Romicide Propaganda 101. And some scholars take that at face value. And also, there's the whole fact that during the Amarna period, Brianna, if I'm saying like bullshit, you need to stop me and tell me, you know, come out of the ocean.
Oh, but I always say bullshit, so I won't.
The art. If I'm saying something that's not exact. So the art changes, and representation of Akhenaten are very different from others. They're not less idealized. They're just different. He has a very long face, like kind of triangular. He has large eyes. He has this very straight nose. He has a body that has like kind of large hips that could be considered as feminine. Some people find it disturbing. Some other people just jumped up and said, that's it. He was like physically deformed, and those are clearly, you know, portraits in which he decided to be represented as he was, which makes no sense at all if you know anything about Egyptian art. And other people have tried to do a psychoanalysis of Akhenaten and say, oh, he was, he suffered from mania, and he had like, you know, a bipolar disorder, and he had very high highs and very low lows.
Just, I find really problematic when people, even more so when people go into that, because you can't know something like that.
Yeah. He's dead. You can't know. You can't know. And it's also like pretty offensive to people who are actually like, you know, who have like diagnosed mental, how do you call them, illnesses now? Whatever, and they're suffering from it right now, and you're like, oh yeah, he was a freak, and like, well, thank you very much, right? So it's like, and that's also like stupid, because we can't know these people, and also you can't know something from official art. So it's questionable and problematic. Also, like, he's the only one for which people do this, because you don't see people doing this for more traditional rulers, right? It's always Akhenaten, it's only ever Akhenaten. So there's like Ramesside propaganda, and then there's Freud on top, don't get me started, and then like all this shit. And you know, it's a lot, it's a mess. If I were you, Brianna, I'd take a dive and see if there's anything there. From the chat, so the pictures of Akhenaten with his distinctive physical appearance are more likely to be stylized than realistic.
Yes.
Or we just don't know around likely to ever know. No, yes.
Especially
no representation of Pharaoh that is realistic. That's not a thing that you do in Egypt.
And also, it should be pointed out that even the everyday people in the art was depicted the same way as Akhenaten. So it wasn't just him portrayed in this way. It became a style of art that was applied to all human figures.
Yeah, so like someone said everyone looked like a misfired pot, which I find hilarious. I mean, it's offensive, but it's kind of, they're like, oh, yeah, not everyone is like chiseled, you know, chiseled features and perfect cheekbones and like sculpted abs. Yeah, people have like a little pot belly, so what? So, I mean, human beings do that. And then there's the whole pseudo-archaeology shit that people took with the elongated skulls. They're like, oh, clearly that's proof that they were, you know, bandaging the skulls, or they were aliens, or whatever. And once again, no, it's just art, right? Yeah, the crystal skull example. But like, you can't... Don't die. But yes, you can't diagnose someone based on the records that we have of them, especially if those records are not from them, but from people who had every intention misrepresenting them, right? If you look at the records that we have of Akhenaten from his time, he seems, and I can't believe I'm about to utter these words, a pretty chill guy. There are very nice representations of him with his family, with his daughters. He had like a shit ton of daughters, and they're like, you know, Brianna has seen this guy.
Wow! It's his...
So yeah.
Karnak Colossi.
Yep, that's it. So we see Akhenaten in his weird form. This one is Tay. So there should be an entrance to this place.
Hold on, I'm gonna look at his cartouches.
I mean, this is just literally Indiana Jones 1, isn't it? Like, it's illuminated by the sun if you go to the right
place. Yes, exactly.
Oh, interesting.
It's interesting and weird that they sort of feel the need to do those kind of things when they want to have like intrigue in a historical context.
Like, yeah, we always,
you know, like with the angels and demons thing as well, like with the pointing, like it has to be
exactly.
Like a secret way that somehow no one has noticed for 3,000 years.
And exactly, and no one has moved the statue.
Yeah, exactly. Like, or it hasn't broken. I mean,
yeah, exactly. Like arms fall off all the time, but no, somehow. So you now need to find the entrance on that wall.
It's on this wall? This side wall?
It's on the... I think it's on the other wall where you found the Colossus.
Oh.
I think it's easier if you go out of the water a little bit and then look.
Yeah.
Here?
Yeah, it's like it's on the western wall, I think. Like that one.
There's the light that's supposed to shine on the entrance.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. There you go. Bam. That's it.
Yay!
It is Indiana Jones, basically. Yeah, look at that. Oh, yeah.
Because that's totally realistic.
Yeah, you can also use the animal,
the
animal's
pulse,
like a sonar.
The Temple of the Aten.
Okay.
Is there a way to get air?
In there? I don't think so. Oh, maybe up there.
Oh, yeah.
There's like a hole there.
Sometimes there's weapons that give you unlimited air.
Not in this one.
No, there is a thing, an ability that does that. Yeah, it's
nice.
One of these things. This one, the lungs. But I don't have any ability points, so.
Okay.
It's okay. We'll get there. All right. What am I meant to do here? Oh, I'm supposed to investigate.
Look for things.
Oh, that's easy. They're right there. Okay. I like that he can fight and talk underwater.
Living Aten, who started
life, he's
bringing forth the seed of Amenhotep.
Interesting. So they say Amenhotep, but also Aten at the same time. So maybe this is the transition phase.
The womb of his mother, the great royal wife Queen Taia.
He had a period of time which seems like he was trying to decide who he wanted to be and how he wanted to be addressed. Akhenaten was not his birth name, nor was it one of his throne names. Every pharaoh has like 5 names, and only the last one is the one that you're given at birth. But he changes. His actual name was Amun-Hodep, like his dad. And then he changed it when he changed his whole political program. Although, shall we get a little gossipy here? He was not supposed to get on the throne. He had an elder brother. Was a cat lover who died before he could access the throne, and so Amun-Hotep, aka Akhenaten, became the heir. But his other brother Thutmosis is the one who made a beautiful sarcophagus for his cat, whose name was the female cat. So we love him because he was a cat boy.
Oh, soul god without equal.
End of the gossip.
Your eternal resting place will live forever in the sands. You sleep with your...
Alright, I need to get more air. Because I don't want to die. Gosh, this is, I feel like it's taking forever here. Where's my... Aha. There it is. Can't they have... You know, this is hilarious because the Aten temples were open to the air. There weren't roofs on them.
Oh, yeah.
So, sun is supposed to get
why is there a roof on this? You would think that you'd be able to just slide up any time.
Yeah.
That's hilarious.
Right, well, but this one is a special one. I mean, we may or may not see an Aten temple today. Depends.
It's more colossi. Oh, there's a thing.
Of course, yeah, it's there. You can
the Pharaoh Akhenaten holding a relic.
To identify things.
He worshipped it as the god Aten incarnate. If the Pharaoh had the relic, then who has it now?
What relic?
Well, his same relic. But he means artifacts, so he means one of those shiny Izu orbs.
Oh!
Right? It's weird because at the beginning he says artifact and then he says relic. And like, wait,
Isidora must face the truth.
And then I was like, oh,
this is not Amun's will. I need to speak.
That's the thing. And so he has this issue. It's like, well, I gotta tell Isidora because there's something fishy around here. Also, the light never moves, so you can always find the answer.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, really? Where is it coming from? Oh, it's coming from there. I want to look at the source. Will.
I need to speak to her.
How weird.
See how I can put the pharaoh to rest.
Yeah, we're like
oh, they're mirrors. There's another mirror on that column.
Yeah, exactly, and for older gamers in many, many Tomb Raider games, we have the mirror things. Also in Zelda somehow.
Never played Zelda. We didn't have like any when we were growing up.
Guys, well, when Breath of the Wild 2 comes out.
Mm.
We may consider it for science.
For science.
No, for the arts. But yeah. So this is where like the game gets a bit more on the lore and a bit less on the religion.
Mm.
Because you have, you know, the let's say the pretext to start the quest is kind of religious, because Amunet tells you, oh, there's one of these things. But then you get taken away by the fact that there's mummies that are rising and things are happening. And then the high priestess tells you, well, there's shit going on. And then people tell you they're looting the necropolis. And then you get taken back to order by the fact that there's
this
artifact around. James, there are no henges in Egypt, but I can point out many, many points here. Oh, that's my Zoom background. Also, that's not where she is. No,
some awesome soup.
Oh,
yeah.
Where's the inside? Oh, it's this direction.
Oh yeah, I think you can see it. Whoa! I think there's like half walls.
Whoa!
Oh yeah.
This is intense.
Oh yeah. This is very cool. They're just going on the ground. She's upstairs, cool. But like on the other, yeah.
Wait, what?
But this is really cool.
There's treasure over here. Let's take it. Carbon crystal. I knew it was going to be a carbon crystal.
We need it.
Wait. Okay. How do I get inside that area? Because the other area was a dead end.
No. It's a half wall in the other area. If I'm not mistaken.
In here?
Yeah. I think you can climb up.
Oh, I see.
There you go. Yeah, there's openings. Convenient.
Up. I'm pressing the button. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, you have to press it. Yeah, exactly. And now you can. And they're conducting mummification. Which is not really what... No.
They do that a lot in the temples. There's a lot of mummification happening in temples, I notice.
Yeah, which is not where it would happen. In the House of Life, which was a separated thing.
I guess here's another grim harvest.
Also, this woman is fabulous.
Did you find the answer in the farmlands?
I found this.
You dare bring this into Amun's house?
I found it in a temple dedicated to the apostate Akhenaten. What is he holding?
He worshipped the disk of the sun.
The
atom.
The apostate. Wow, yeah.
It is not the sun he
really
is holding.
What's there?
Yeah.
It is the relic I seek.
Yeah, exactly.
This and the man who has it now are behind the cast.
Like,
not Amun.
Woman. You and your religion.
Is this Amun's will? Huh? That he sends a heretic, the pharaoh who denounced him?
Tuya. No.
Tuya,
sent you out into Thebes.
Was the mother of Queen Thebes.
She would be safe. I did this.
Akhenaten still walks. He is the key to the relic.
I have been blind.
hiding behind Amun's veil.
There's been a lot of scarabs. Like, a lot of scarabs. Like, an ungodly amount of scarabs.
This may not be Amun, but Amun can stop him.
This is not the gods. Don't you understand?
The Lord to the Limit still holds dominion over Thebes. And I am Amun's wife. The people need to know that he still hears their cries.
Then tell me his will.
A single speck of dust from the god's statue of Amun. It would purify Ahenaten's resting place in the valley amongst the true kings. Tihon has taken everything of value from the temples and the tombs. We have nothing left.
This is not the first time I've heard of his thievery.
We have nothing left, she says, as she's literally
his men harass the farmlands.
Yes! Yeah. He lords it over us.
Look how poor we are!
Struts like a scorpion around Hatshepsut's temple.
Ma'am, you have
then I will find him and his spoils.
Hatshepsut's temple? I get to go see...
The man who has your relic.
Oh, yeah.
What will you do when you find him?
Yeah. We are going to the West Bank.
Then Amun watch over you.
I was in Luxor once and I was taking the ferry to the West Bank, and the ferry for foreigners cost 5 Egyptian pounds.
Tihon conducts his business around Hatshepsut.
And the guy who wants to sell the, or he wants to give you a ride on the motorboats.
Let's hope this thief keeps a record of his spoils.
I asked him, okay, so how much is the motorboat? He's like, oh, 20 Egyptian pounds. And I said to him, why would I pay 20 pounds when I can pay 5 and take the ferry? And he was like, oh, but it's faster. And I'm like, okay, but 5 minutes, it really doesn't make that much of a difference. Okay, so shall I continue? Oh, it's in red.
No, I'm checking out... Which of the quests will actually take you to another quest? Because we need to keep Akhenaten for later.
Should I start this
one?
You
can do No Honor. You can start No Honor Among Thieves.
All right.
Which is a play on No Honor Among Thieves. Yeah. And that one. The quest immediately after that one will have a title that will make you think. So you can do that one.
That one,
right.
3,000 XP, which is like an entire.
Yeah, game. It's a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you will like. Yeah, you can do that. Like you, because it's like it's not linear. So there's like. But this one was cool to do because of all the ads and stuff.
Yes.
But we have to stop. We have to stop with Akhenaten himself for now, but we'll see. I think we can do like this one, and then you can see the title of the next quest, and then we'll see.
Look at all these exclamation marks! Some good side quests in here. What is this guy wearing? What is this striped nonsense? Houndstooth! Houndstooth nonsense. Hilarious. Excuse me.
Please.
Excuse me.
Sorry. Ma'am.
Honk. I really took the scenic route, didn't I? Oh, look at the West Bank over there! Hold on, let's I wanna see it. I mean, I won't go all the way. Well, I kinda do have to go all the way over there anyway.
We stand in the hall of
Tutu. You can see the temple of Hatshepsut. Wow. The landscape is almost correct back there.
With the big cliffs.
Yeah. There's a whole ledge. That's not complete though. Whoops, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to climb on top. Let me just climb on top of this one. Can I see it from here? Oh no, there's a big building in the way. Oh, hello, yes!
Have we done like a synchronization point yet? Like the viewpoint?
Oh yeah, we haven't synchronized yet also.
Yeah, I should. Yeah. Oh my god. Oh, I have things to say. The temple of Nebhepet-Re, Mentuhotep, has a pyramid there, but now scholars think it was a flat top terrace. Like the rest of the...
We have advanced our knowledge and our ideas about how these temples looked. So this is actually archaeology in the archaeology now, because the reconstruction with the pyramid is not current anymore. But it's fantastic.
But there should be a ledge right on top of where this is. They have part of it, which is right here. They have part of that ledge, but it should go the whole way around. All the way around this bend here to the Valley of the Kings, and I have walked that, and it was really freaking cool, man. Just wanted to flex that, so.
Oh no, you need to flex that. Also, you will know, chat, you'll notice that all of these mortuary temples on the other side have like a dock area, which is with a sort of basin, which is absolutely true, because you would have that for, the barges moving. We've lost many of them. Some of this stuff now is, like, underwater, under marshes, the Nile has moved. It's stuff.
It just said I'm in the Theban necropolis. But I'm not. Maybe...
it's okay.
Weird. Maybe it was because Senu traveled over there.
Yeah, probably that. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, the necropolis is on the other side.
The relic was stolen from the pharaoh's tomb.
Other subplot, which
someone
is
here must know the thief.
Which is, something that happened. We know it happened. We have,
welcome,
Senny.
Siamen's Curios. Are you looking for something special?
Thieves being caught,
I have
and,
the rarest
stuff. You know,
the
confessions.
An artifact. From the tombs.
Physical punishment,
such a treasure.
All sort
of the pharaoh's ransom.
The moment you
but not
the tool,
here, Neb. Soldiers are stupid, but their swords are sharp.
People will speak, especially if they're bribed, and so,
Not many
matches were sent like to older tombs, more ancient tombs.
Now why is that?
Are fair game, and
you
not just royal tombs, but like everyone's tombs.
Black
like, we know that at a certain
relics
point, it was lined up wood, so
trust
people would break into tombs to get
but
a sarcophagi to bury their own people.
You alone
so
amongst all the merchants.
Some might take advantage of a man fresh off the boat in Thebes. Once who lived.
But yeah, these people are just reselling, stuff that they found inside the tomb. That's why it's vintage.
Vintage.
Enough there. Beard and bear. Someone in the chat asks, this NPC and lots of NPCs called Bayek Seni, so is Seru the feminine version of that name? Does it mean something like lady?
It's Sen is like brother. So I don't know. I think they were when they used the term Seni, for feminine it would be Senet.
Yeah.
Whenever I hear Seni, I think that's my brother or like my friend. I'm unprepared.
No,
you will pay. There's lots of game research sites that the early play in cultures.
Yeah.
Then if you play the Forgotten City, then you go to the Egyptian level of the city, you can find pieces of the Senet game.
And if you play Tomb Raider the Last Generation, you play Senet against the spirit of the deceased, but it's a giant version of Senet.
So it's like the Harry Potter thing.
Let's
like
try this again.
Yes.
I'm looking for an artifact stolen from the tombs.
Oh, that artifact. Yes, but Ursu must
let's
not
try
know
again.
He
spoke. Let's try again, but Bayek is trying to be nice. Let's try again, or I'm breaking.
You really don't know
anything. Yes. I like to imagine
to
that everyone like
stealing their
ingredients has like an Italian accent.
There is
because,
an auction.
It speaks to my
very exclusive. I tried to get
somehow
in, but Ursu and I don't see eye to eye.
Where can I get an invitation?
To Hemet as well.
There is an auction.
The historian.
I tried to get in.
I tried to win it from her in our last death game. We play on the roof north of
and now we're gonna meet another one. Like, she's probably
that's
my favorite character.
Just
in this one.
Let me live.
We're going to meet a historian. But she's not the historian you expect. She's an unsavory character, and I love her so much. To the left, to the left.
Ha. Huh. Alright.
Let's go. Let's go hunt for history. Oh, this is fantastic.
I'm excited.
Yeah, I hope, Alex, I hope you're not taken aback by all the information we're dumping on this.
Not at all. I mean, I know some things about this period, but I mean,
you did your research.
Yeah, but like Brianna said, like if you don't have that background, then I think it's all just like compact.
Ah, beetle down from a horse's ass. What is this?
Some good gambling.
Let me roll again.
She's the historian.
If I lose, I'll give
She's
you twice what I offer.
By all means.
She's a very serious scholar.
I know you have an invitation.
Well,
I will play you.
Published
in I have points. Yeah, I mean,
maybe I want to keep my invitation. Ever thought of that?
I guarantee you cannot possibly want it more than me.
I like this guy's red hair.
Please. My mother, she's sick. She has one wish.
Your uncle is a better liar. Who invited the
thug? That's a good question. I don't know.
With you?
But Brianna, take the red hair and put like the back of your head, and we'll come back to that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Some of the names.
Hey up, woman.
Some of the names I encountered in this game are like modern, Middle Eastern names.
It was like
an
Odyssey, I guess.
Yeah.
You're hiding muscle now, Tehemet. You better leave.
Hey, I'm pressing buttons.
Guess what? You're gonna have some people.
Probably wouldn't have been there.
Oh, blessed. Got a big guy here.
Like
okay. Oh, blessed.
Yeah.
I hate these guys with the clubs.
Yeah, they're Goliaths. Die.
You are
finished. He died from the the fumes.
Watched him die like that.
Oh, love it.
Now, Hammond has a great arm bracelet, which is an actual reproduction of a.
I already lost all my money.
Is a snake that coils
I do not need coin.
I
need
think
information.
The Metropolitan Museum sells the reproduction.
And your invitation.
Because I think it's one of them. Auction. There's one of them.
You heard what I told
museum.
That rust-haired Claude Pet Sutek. Like,
but the boy did not just save your life, damn it.
So cool.
All right. It's
also,
all
yes,
getting a little
sneaky,
hot for my blood anyway. Desecration, curses, pharaohs returning from the dead.
Do you know what Irsu is selling?
Whatever it was,
she's like, eh,
brought the curse down upon us.
Is that the pharaohs returning from the dead?
Irsu
eh?
Is a crook. He and his cronies found
like
Queen Nefertiti's tomb, stole something from it.
Literally,
and now she wants it back.
Back to life
no one deserves
story,
death more
say,
than
know,
that
okay.
dung peddler.
Like, yeah,
but she comes
she's
for
not a good historian.
She has the
my invitation is at my villa,
near
the entrance to Kana. Take it.
She's got a nose ring.
The gods.
She's so cool.
You'll see.
She's so
I have
cool.
a game
it's
on the other side of Thebes.
To see, like,
may the dice fall in your favor, bye.
Woman who is not an overly sexualized, you know, nymph-like female character.
Mm.
Like, it's finally to see someone with some, you know, with some flesh. You know, and someone who's not like a 20-year-old who weighs like 50 kilos. Like, it's true to have some body members. Finally, right? I know someone who's built, or not someone who's built like a wardrobe, like in Valhalla, where every woman is either like too thin or like giant. Like,
yeah.
There's body shapes, guys. There's
we stand in the hall of two truths. Offer our hearts for judgment.
Sorry,
that we might be found
Maheru,
true of voice. The wearer of hearts turns his burning
sure
eyes upon us.
That
places the feather on the scale.
I think
you
really
believe it. Yeah, everyone's like kind of. The
maybe
right
the
color.
Hemet study is somewhere kind of. Underneath.
Hmm. I have to sneak away in here. Oh, we got a curtain.
This is for Mehen.
Very convenient curtain.
The game of Snake. I used to play it with
Mehen. Oh, cool. I don't recall Mehen having dice, but
it's basically like a snake coiled, and like the coils are divided into like a checkered pattern, but we don't know the rules.
Oh. Okay.
We don't exist, but we don't know the rules. Is that a mathematical papyrus?
Yes.
Is that Pythagoras?
That's Pythagoras' theorem. Yes.
What? Can you zoom in on that? Like, is it actually Greek?
Yeah, that's...
Oh my god,
yeah.
That's
yeah, it is.
Oh, Pythagoras. Oh my god.
That's fantastic.
And so, oh wait. Is this modern Greek? That's Pythagoras or...
It's in Greek with Arabic letters.
It literally says before Christ.
Oh my god.
Really?
Wow, okay.
That's fantastic.
They, like, pick, Greek in Wikipedia and just put it there.
I think they did, but...
Look at that.
Can you zoom in more? Oh,
585
to
500 pi.
Oh no. Oh no.
Oh my god. This is... I'm gonna look this up. This is probably just Wikipedia.
Oh man, you guys, we're heading into we're actually researching now. Look at that. We're serious.
But it may also be like putting some math. This is like a weird choice.
They had a Book of the Dead judgment scene papyrus on display as art in one of the Roman camps that I raided.
Yes, about
which I thought was really funny. It's like, it's not really artwork.
His name and the date, I mean, they... It's not Wikipedia. I mean, Pythagoras or Samios is correct from Wikipedia, but the date on Wikipedia is 496, and here it says 500. So that's weird. And then, can you move a little bit to the right?
Oops.
Yeah, it's like some great future telling. They must have had a great seer.
Like over here?
No, maybe a little bit back. I'm sorry. But it says, yeah, the Philosophiki. This is literally like effort of the philosophical school of, I can't read that, of big, is it Magna Graecia Michaelis or level?
Oh my god.
So I guess this isn't the one at the Turin Museum.
No, it's not. so the Turin Museum holds an excellent papyrus, which we cannot link here because it's highly not safe for work. It's called the Erotic Papyrus, and it represents an orgy. There is a giant mushroom in the orgy, and it's being used exactly how you imagine it's being used. So if you look up Turin Erotic Papyrus, that will show up, and it's art. Anyways, so no, they're not using that here. We also have like good mathematical papyri from ancient Egypt, and they're not using them here, which is a weird choice.
Mm-hmm.
If I just, what is the word, like the first word on the, like, you have the date of his life and then this, the two lines below it, like the first word, what is that? Okay.
You're asking the wrong person.
If you zoom in a little bit more, I mean.
It gets quite blurry though, doesn't it? Well, you can really see the texture of the papyrus.
that is nice. Yeah, so I can't find like a direct thing, but it's. I mean, I find something like a philosophical.
Here you go. This looks better.
I found what I'm gonna be doing this weekend.
This is clear now. Can you read it now?
Cases are all promised.
It's the SpongeBob meme. Crap on.
Oh wait, I found it.
Oh,
for real?
It's from a blog. From a blog, Ithia blog. www.blogspot.com.
Oh my god.
It's the exact same text.
Did they copy and paste from the internet?
I think they did, but where is it? Exactly. Yeah, literally, they didn't literally copy paste it, but it's, I found like the exact words in the exact sequence on this webpage.
Oh my god, that's so crazy.
It's amazing, but not in a good way, yes.
Okay, yeah,
all
I'm
right.
Sorry, we can move on, but...
okay, it's okay.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
The weird things we discover.
Yeah, right, well, this is what we do. We're nerds. So, this is what
we do. We have a funerary mask over here.
Go back to the papyrus. There's actually an investigation point on the papyrus, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Oh!
Oh, yeah.
Incorrect.
Did so much
like,
builders' traps?
Then...
Ingenious. Some of the means by which the builders protected the mastaba from looters are incredible. Hidden passages, pits, false chambers. I have even heard tell of platforms with ropes and pulleys which must be manipulated to reach the treasure rooms. What has this to
it's
do
geometry.
With any of this?
Using
That's
Pythagoras.
Geometry. Using Pythagoras. They're throwing Pythagoras at the looters.
Yeah. Oh, you know, the pyramids were constructed using Pythagoras. No,
that's so weird.
We have a boat.
Yeah, I saw. Can I?
Can you kill?
How do I do that?
That's interesting.
Okay. I don't really see how any of that was related to anything. Wait, where's this lady? How am I supposed to get to her? She's on the bottom here.
You need to find a way downstairs.
Yes.
My understanding is that most of stuff about trap tombs is pure fiction. Yes. There can be a pit in some tombs, but it's not a pit to kill looters. It is a pit to, from what I was taught when I was studying, so I don't know how the consensus is right now. Is it a pit to represent the cavern that is the body of the underworld god Sokar, whose tummy is literally a cavern? But it's not to make people fall into the holes.
But also, it does have a practical purpose in that it's in case there's a flash flood, which happens.
Oh yeah,
which happens,
it could. Water goes down and the tomb is not damaged.
Yeah.
I think you can enter the place maybe from above. I'm thinking, I don't remember anything about this house, but I think you can go on the rooftop and then jump down. I think it seems to make the most sense. Let's see. Like, there must be a hole somewhere.
Looks like it has like a fence on the top, like on the roof.
Yeah, what's under that awning with all the great leaves?
Oh, we got a cat! We got a cat making an appearance.
Kitty!
There's a cat.
On my desk, and he wandered off.
Yeah.
So this is what's under the awning.
Where's the entrance? Can you? Yeah. Oh wait, there was another door on the other side of the top floor. On the little balcony.
Over there. Oh, isn't this the same room?
I don't know, man. See?
Yeah, it's the same room.
Is there a stairway down or something?
Yeah, there is one. Oh, wait a minute.
From inside. Oh yeah, there is. Oh, we're fine.
What was it that Tahemet said?
You people should know that
if the gods allow.
Beautiful cats. We might see one.
He's sitting here staring at me. What?
He is a prince among cats.
Wheels.
His beauty, his grace.
Perhaps the statues can be
giant
turned.
Paws. And yeah, his name is Bagheera.
Mm-hmm.
And he is gray and chunk. And very smart.
And a diva.
And a diva, yes. He has a high opinion of himself, as he should. The other one is basically a dinosaur.
Yes.
Her name is Topaz. She's a tabby. So we may also see her.
Puzzle poem.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, now they're doing that trope.
Yes, once again.
The ancient riddle.
Okay, how do I, there's the wheel there, but how do I interact with it?
You
there it is. All right. You have to be in a very specific... Ooh, my controller is vibrating. How many times do I have to turn the wheels?
The poem said they had to face each other.
Oh.
So I would have... That one, you can't move. You can move the two jackals, I think. The poem said that they had to kind of face each other and then the door opened.
Aha! I see. Look at that.
Ding, ding, ding.
One more go. So he's looking...
Can you move the other statue though? Like the other jackal? Because maybe like this one also moves a moon?
Oh, they all move a moon. That's lame.
This bitch. Okay, see if you can make them face each other and see if it opens the door.
I don't like having to think in this game. That's not fair.
Yeah, we just like to destroy things, really.
I mean, they're facing each other, so...
No. They need to face each other. Like, the two jackals need to face each other. Now they're facing...
Oh.
When you move one jackal, the other one doesn't move. It just moves.
Oh, okay,
Yeah.
I thought it was, it might be like a... One of those, that Spider-Man meme where they have to...
You
gotta point at
each
other.
Yeah. Okay, so that one's fine, and then I'll turn the other one and see if it's if it will open. A very specific point.
It's moving this wheel thing. Hurrah!
There you go.
That did it.
Oh, I thought that was a carpet. It was not.
Oh, it just appeared.
Yes.
There's a hole.
He entered the investigation area. All right. Wow, and he's quite the detective in this.
Virus from the old kingdom.
The camel's fake
sarcophagus. Myths of the Pharaohs.
So I guess if you start this part of the DLC first, I guess this is what's going to give you the background information for the Akhenaten one when you read these materials here.
Papyrus from the old kingdom.
Yeah, that you're finding out about it on Papyrus. On Papyri.
The hermit has been researching the root of the curse.
Yeah, that's fair.
Joined in their heresy. What does this mean for the source of the curse?
I don't know if it spawns here. He's like, just put a hand there. It's not like there may be a cobra or something. Ooh.
How much more bloodshed and madness will this one bring?
The orb. Bayek is pondering the orb.
Oh, yes. I was also pondering that orb because it was very...
I should hurry to the island before the relic is
sold. The one with his friend. They didn't really go into detail with that.
They were like, it's an orb. I'm like,
oh. Alright, so shall we do Lady of Grace?
I think yes. I think we should start Lady of Grace and then you will know where to stop. Reach the auction site. Also, does the name suggest anything to you?
Okay.
I mean,
back upstairs we go.
Yeah, go. So there's going to be an auction. Because, you know, these people are not just gamblers and marauders, but they also sell the stuff as it should be. So we're going to participate in an auction. I would go there just in case.
Look at these soldiers.
Be, I think it's going to be on the other side of the Nile, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, wow.
This place is heavily guarded.
Oh, man. I pressed the assassinate button too late. Darn. Alright, let's chain throw here. You are dead and you... Oh, you are... I'm beating your shield instead of you. I got stuck.
Oh no, okay.
You had a couple of dropped frames, or a few, like 139 of them.
It's okay.
I mean, someone in the chat, I don't remember, but the quality of the video has been fantastic.
It's perfect, right? It's
thank so goodness. Yeah. So my $90 a month internet is actually paying off. Miraculous.
Yeah, that's a bad resolution is fantastic.
Almost looks like if you're playing
yourself.
Yeah.
Let's go, sir, move.
Ooh, are we taking the ferry for 5 Egyptian pounds?
I don't know. I mean, can they convince Bayek to take the ferry for 5 Egyptian pounds?
Or the motorboat for 20? To get there faster.
Would you try to convince a man in a towel to pay 20 when he should pay 5? Yeah, they would. There's a boat that you can steal.
This one?
Yeah.
That would be so funny if you could actually commandeer one of these things.
Like, that's it, we're commandeering. I think there's one on the dock on the side.
Whoops! What am I doing? Here, move over there. Move where I told you to go. It's over there. Theban dock guard post. Oh, some toilets! Oh, those aren't toilets. I always like encountering the guys who are peeing and then assassinating them.
Yes, that's fair. Someone had to render that and we salute them.
I kill you!
You know.
Who?
Oh, yeah, I think you.
Who's killing
I think
me?
You can steal.
You sure about that, my dude? Oh wait, you just caught yourself on fire.
That's okay then. That's fine. Goodbye, sir.
Oh man, you messed up my chain throw. I'm gonna bust you up, man. That's what I'm gonna do. Actually, I guess I'm not. He's one of those powerful ones. Alright, maybe I'll just try to take this. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna jump in the water. And I'm gonna go for a swim. To this boat over here. I'm gonna make this guy move, and I'll commandeer his boat.
If you swim long enough, like a red black spawn.
Yeah, he talks about how he needs.
That's fantastic. I love it. I like the times when you can assassinate someone on the fortress wall and you just throw them off the wall. And then you can watch them fall to their death. It's absolutely fantastic.
Oh yes. All right. Watching time. My need is great. Yes.
I hope you enjoyed the ride, my friend.
Next time I'm commandeering like a god boss or a car, like my need is great.
There's enemies here. I wasn't prepared for that.
I told you to go there armed.
Predator attack. Oh, is he attacking the guy in the boat?
Oh my god.
Ah, it is!
So one of them jumped into the water, the other one is attacked by a hippo.
Nice. What's gonna happen to the third one? Yeah. I mean, you're gonna have to kill them anyways, so might as well.
All right.
Nice. though.
Blast!
The end has come for you.
Oh wait, I've got my Oh, actually, they're quite easy. I'm not gonna waste my time. I'm not gonna waste my adrenaline on these nobodies.
These peasants. Oh, see that one? The one? Yeah, but then again, he jumped straight into death. So.
I guess he wasn't fast enough.
Guess he jumped to his demise. And someone else has
I
to
have thugs.
What the fuck is a crocodile?
Where are the merchants
doing there?
They were paid to protect?
That's okay.
Oh, I need to replenish my arrows. Oh, I don't need to. I picked them all up, I guess. Alright. Got a lot of dead dudes over here. That's the way I like them. We need more. Aha, there's one.
The relic replaced with a half-eaten apple. The thief has a sense of humor.
Hardy har har.
LOL.
You know, I would really like to throw out a verbal poll. How many people say LOL and how many people say LOL? Because I actually say the acronym LOL.
No, I say LOL, generally.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
LOL. Someone ran away from the auction.
Yeah, replace it with
Then again, in Dutch, the word LOL just exists as fuck.
Where did they come from? Maybe from that wharf across the river?
Investigating more.
They took prisoners.
Where did they come from? Well, I don't know.
This one died before they could get him on the boat.
Ooh, cutscene.
The auction was underway when the soldiers arrived.
Investigation.
In the chaos, someone saw an opportunity to take the relic. But was it soldiers or someone else? They killed the bodyguards, but captured the merchants and took them across the water to Hatshepsut Sanctuary.
Ooh.
One way or another, the path to the relic leads there.
Yes. Yes! Alright, it is time for some epic fun here. Where's my little guy with the boat? Did he get killed by the hippo?
Sorry, sir, did you die?
The boat is missing.
There's a skiff there, though.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, is that him? Or is that a soldier? Oh, I think this was my passenger.
Oh,
or is it? Yeah, I was. Sorry, buddy. But I had tasks to complete. So let's go get my little skiff. Mm-hmm. Phew. All right.
Okay, so.
Off we go.
I have a suggestion.
Oops. Yes?
Since we're going for 2 hours and 20. That, like, we get to where we have to get now, which is the other side, and then next week we attempt Deir al-Bahri and what comes next.
Okay.
Because Deir al-Bahri is big, and it requires either a lot of stealth or a lot of fighting.
And a lot of commentary.
And a lot of commentary, and what happens next will also require a lot of commentary. So I think, like, once you get to the other side, we can, you know, maybe wrap it, and then next time we'll jump straight in.
Gotcha.
And get into the thing, if that's acceptable.
Yes, it is.
Okay, good. We got like some can happen today, and we'll get some Nefertiti. We got some information about Nefertiti, and then next time we can jump straight, you know, into the action and see how to better approach the mission Deir al-Bahri. But you can get like as close as you want.
Actually,
look at it because I know you want to.
I'm gonna park at the wharf here.
Exactly. And then next time we'll
Can I just assassinate this guy first?
Of course you can.
Oh shit!
Kill you!
That's not fair. I was pressing the button. All right. You get to experience my... No. He was pointing in the wrong direction. Seriously, dude. Are you kidding me?
You die. Oh my god.
That is so frustrating. Alright. Alright. Now you get to experience my adrenaline. Chain through in the wall. Alright. You guys are just armed with bows and arrows, so...
So angry.
Really slaughter you here. Nice. Okay.
Your arrows.
I think they're... Yeah, I got them already. Oh, there's a guy over there. Well, whatever. Alright, I just want to climb up on top here and get a lay of the land.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll let that shade kill everyone else. But, wow, look, you guys, I'm so excited!
So happy.
And obelisks that weren't actually there, but that's okay.
That's fine.
Wow, they've got quite a row of obelisks, too. Look at that. There's like...
Someone in the chat said that we have the discussion about how this is New Kingdom themes, late period at least. We touched upon that. We also touched upon the fact that people would not have known who the fuck Akhenaten was. And they just keep, you know, name dropping him. Like, you know, oh yeah, Akhenaten, that guy.
They also wouldn't have known that Pythagoras was so many years before Christ.
Exactly. Yes, they would not have read them before Christ.
No.
Yeah, you're right, yeah. All right, so is this where we're stopping our stream?
I mean, you can go as close to their boundary as you want, and then we can talk.
Is there a synchronization point that we can do here that would be like
a nice... let's see. If you open the map, I don't think there's one that we can do here. I think the closest one is in...
What is this, like the Gurn? Yeah. This is that mountain, the Merit Sager mountain, maybe?
Yeah,
but
it's
looks like that's the closest
one. Yeah, that's
a bit
far.
Yeah.
No, I think we can stop here.
Okay. Yeah, I want to save the excitement of Hatshepsut's temple for next time. So we'll hang out back here.
Next time, in for a treat or several treats. Or
is that a Mamisi?
It looks like a Mamisi. All right. Well, thank you everyone for joining us. You were a lot of people, and chat was really active.
Yes, thank you.
Same time, same place next week. We're really happy that this had like a good, you know, resonance with people. We had opinions, we had things. Next time, more Egyptology, more mummies, more royal family of Amarna. 2 p.m. Easter time. You will find all of our links on Twitter, on Instagram, on Facebook. If you're on Facebook, you'll find all the link to Brianna's, or should I say Dr. Jackson's, other projects and personal pages everywhere. And next time we will still have a sexy man running around in a towel. So there is that.
Uh-oh.
Thank you, Alex, for, you know, enduring two Egyptologists freaking out.
I froze us.
Non-Egyptologist. Oh, did it?
Yeah, it's because I'm preparing to press stop streaming, changed windows. I'm sorry, guys.
Okay, it's fine. Okay, so this is a great time to finish the stream. Thank you, Brianna.
See y'all next week.
All right, bye.
Bye.